have it? Do you have it? Do you have it?
So I'm Austin, and I was a contestant on Guts.
This is Sherry.
My stuff. I'm pretty much homeless, I guess you could say, but I sleep indoors in the basement of a three flat. They don't really know I live there. Yeah, I've experimented with drugs a little bit. My worst enemy. I love Christopher Walken. There was a lot of messed up stuff that went on that show.
Who cares what it felt like? She won!
Mike O'Malley. Mike, he drank a lot. You could tell when he was asking people to spill their guts.
If he keeps this up, he's going to be the most popular guy in his town, JP! Now it's time for Christina to spill her guts. Spill your gut.
Sometimes he would ask it in a very strange way.
Fly, Robin, fly! Plenty more to play, but now it's time for Jules to spill her gut. So, Julie, spill your gut!
He would throw in bits about Spike Lee every now and then.
Hey, I think I was thinking Spike Lee. Mo Better Blues, I don't know.
Sometimes he would get really annoyed.
Well, chirp, chirp, said the little bird, but the guts player said it's time to spill your guts.
Sometimes Mike would get really angry. He would, like, throw stuff.
Laura, spill your guts.
Then the creepiest, he'd go,
we're ready. Selena, spill your guts.
Do I regret going on Guts? Every day. Every day of my life, I regret going on Guts.
It's going? I see the red light. It's going? Okay. So I'm Walter Ingelow. I'm here with Petey Kirk. We were both contestants on Nickelodeon's Guts. And I have borrowed the producer's camera, and we're going to do our own little interview. I was champion of season 2 on Guts. I won Piece of the Crag. Petey was on episode 1 of season 2, or season 3. Gonna kick your fucking dairy, yeah, yeah. Give me a camera. Come on, my turn. Give me a camera.
Hello.
You're not English. All right.
I know I'm not. This is Petey Kirk, and I, as my man here said before, I am a Victorian of the Crag. So what kind of questions you got for me?
Alright, when they asked you to spill your guts, what did you tell them?
What were the three things you told them?
That's easy. You know, we like spaghetti and meatballs, big dish, spaghetti and meatballs. I love my mom. That was my second one. And third was, you know, I gotta love that AOL. I love talking to my friends. Well, you know, I live in the local life storage. I gotta float around a little bit, you know, be inconspicuous. And I'm a panhandler. I hold out my hand, or a hand handler, you know what I mean? I hold out my hand and ask for some money and I get it. I'm not a good swimmer. So I put myself in the pool and I had to swim 3 foot waves, we're talking, 3 feet.
So,
now Pete, you got the camera down. Now you ask me questions.
All right, so how Petey like to do interviews? I always like the good, the bad, and the ugly.
Okay.
So give me the good about Guts. What was your favorite experience?
All right, when I was on Guts, I loved the thing when I got to be on the bungee cords, but I really messed up my back. And I wound up taking a lot of painkillers. Mo, she had that fucking fanny pack, and she'd just be like, here, take these. These are candy. And I'd be all like, here, take these. These are candy. And I found out they were kind of like candy. They made me feel really good. But then she started making me do real kind of bad things to keep getting the candy. The shit she would make me do to get those.
What's the worst thing that happened to you from being on Guts?
The worst thing about being on Guts? Is probably HIV. There's no I in team, but there is one in HIV. Mike tells everybody he got it from a tattoo parlor in Tahiti, but he really got it from the 12-year-olds. See, I'd always made fun of a little crippled kids, and I was always just like, But since I did Mo a little favor, she pulled a little Nancy Kerrigan, Tanya Harding, and fucking kneecap this bitch for me. Fucking took her right out of the fucking race. Fucking won that shit. I kind of felt bad because that girl wound up getting really depressed and fucking hanging herself like 3 weeks later. You know, that girl, I mean, she was like 12. After that, I mean, 12's like a tough age. And when you don't win an event and you get your kneecap shattered by a snotty English bitch, you know, sometimes a knotted up electrical cord looks like a fucking good way out. I walk on sunshine in my boogie shoes.
It can happen.
And when you fall hard, because your wings are made of wax and feathers. That's kind of like that story.
Shit, what you got over there?
Dude! Warriors! Come on, play! Warriors! Come on, play! W-A-L-T-E-R I-N-G-E-L-O-W. Walter Ingelow is how I spell guys. Like Britney Spears when she was wearing a fucking snake. And Christina Applegate or Aguilera. Or was it Applegate? The fat one on the show with CeeLo. The small hands. Smells like cabbage. Jack Nicholson, Jack Black, fucking Danny DeVito, Tom Jones, Jim Brown, Pam Grier, Michael J. Fox, Sarah Jessica Parker, Pierce Brosnan, Jeff Foxworthy was around, Charlie Sheen, and Omar Gooding's in jail. What does that tell you? Christopher Walken. I love Christopher Walken. Oh man, yeah, but so we're making this documentary now, and you know, looking back on my life, I wish that I had been on Nick Arcade, because I like video games. I still have a Sega, and I wish I had been on Nick Arcade, because I'm really, really good at Mortal Kombat 2.
How would you spell guts?
I don't know what guts is. I just know about the stomach. But everything else is just me. Success. It's Petey Kirk here. And yo, why I'm on this video, I just gotta let y'all know. You know, I'm spinning my own new rap album. Let me give you the opening line. When it comes to school, I keep it private. Cause it don't mean shit. If you got it, you got it. And what I don't got, I get. Like some hip and some gin, I'm just trying to get lit. Post-game party, quarter of the fifth. You know what's Petey Kirk. But, you know, I'm a winner.
I want to hang out with Charlie Sheen. Thank you.